Hey guys, the game is not starting yet, but I cannot hear this pop music anymore.
Lumi's happy about that. He despises pop music or any sign of joy.
Yes. Why are you smiling, Ted?
Who's smiling?
Good.
Oh, sorry.
So we're going to just talk to chat for a bit.
I'm not in charge of overlays. Lumi's in charge of overlays. Yeah, if the overlays get fucked up, it's all Lumi's fault. It ain't my fault.
I actually enjoy talking to Twitch chat quite a bit.
You do?
Especially in like a very low, like 2K people.
Okay. Yeah, you can actually have a
like
conversation.
Like not 10K.
Yeah.
That's
cool.
That's insane.
Did you see I drew you a picture? I didn't see it, Projekistan. Link that shit.
And James is probably asleep.
James is definitely asleep. He's asleep 20 out of 24 hours.
Yeah, I don't know what exactly James does for this. I think his job is to pay people to come and take a share of the payment.
You better do that. I'll be all over him like a uncomfortable rash. I'm sure he's familiar with those. Speaking of spam, at some point Capitalist puts on Sandstorm and the do-do-do-do's start, and Shords in Tears says, I can't mod this, help. I don't know, who's Shords? Is he a mod on the other dudes?
I guess, I imagine.
I like Katy Perry raw, all right? My kids love Katy Perry.
Yeah, Katy Perry's good.
I like Katy Perry. I would rather listen to 1,000 hours of Katy Perry than 1,000 hours of Dire Straits, to put it that way.
I have not heard Dire Straits. Actually, I have, but I don't think I could evoke as much negative feeling as you have for them.
You got to remember that when I was a kid, Dire Straits were actually still an active band releasing records.
Okay.
And lots of people really loved them.
It's like a lot of people like it, so I won't like
no,
it.
No, not at all. Because, I mean, a lot of people like Katy Perry, and I really like Katy Perry, right?
Okay, yeah.
She's like one of the biggest recording artists in the world. I'm not saying it's nothing to do with like popularity. And I'm like anti-popularity. I love pop music. Some of it. The good stuff. If it's good, it's good. I'm saying that Dire Straits is no good. To me. To my extremely high quality, skillful ears. We're connected.
We'll let it sit for a bit.
Yao, Lin, Didi, Taobao, and Rabbit. That's a good team, right?
That is a good team.
And Shiki, and I don't know the other two characters... names, and then the answer, and maples. What is that in Chinese?
Okay, so the first character, I do mean it's like a tiger.
Tide?
Tiger.
A what?
That's a character for a tiger.
A tiger, okay.
Yes.
And then what's the next one?
It's too many characters. Something
it says,
DJ.
It says something DJ.
I think it's like midnight DJ or afternoon DJ.
Okay.
We just call him the DJ that plays Dire Straits.
Dire Straits DJ.
Dire Straits DJ. So you will be hoping that you suck this game.
Oh, man. Oh, here's the image someone drew. Oh, yeah. Look at this. That's good. A bold dude with a crown, and he's shouting Pyrian Flex. I like that.
Gordo asked me if I watch the two-hour game. Unfortunately, not.
I was asleep.
Yeah, I know.
It was a good time.
After I saw that game on Reddit, I was like, you know what? I'm going to sleep earlier tonight to wake up earlier because... honestly, I should be doing a little bit more research on the Chinese scene because I haven't been seeing any of their games. So, James, sorry, when I say James, I mean the game is loaded. But the game is not loaded yet. And we're just waiting for it.
NA Hub, EU Hub, what's the question marks? We're right here. It is Guts. He's either gonna fail to load in. Is he gonna fail to load in?
Yep.
Oh my god. Do we carry on anyway?
NA Hub disband. No, it won't.
Unbelievable.
Yeah. Those guys, literally unprofessional.
NA Hub.
So I know every time when somebody like reads, somebody asks us if we're excited for the 6 million stretch goal.
Uh huh.
But every time it's like, oh. We now went up by 5,000, 10,000. Like, at this point, I'm immune to that already.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's like, oh, 5 more thousand in the sea of money.
Yeah. I mean, the only funny thing for me is, like, when you think about the stretch goals, the stuff that they give you as stretch goals is, like, a little reward.
Sure.
I kind of think, that sounds cool. And then I think, so wait, if we don't hit the stretch goal, what happens to that cool idea? Do they just go, fuck it, and throw it in the bin and say, oh, you guys didn't earn it? Or do they release it over the next 6 months anyway?
Well, I imagine the cool idea is not something necessary.
Yeah, but I mean...
So they don't have to do it.
That's true. But like Pudge Wars is one of the things, isn't it? So
No. Pudge Wars is not one of those
things. Oh, I thought it was. See, now we're 12 out of 13 again. It's you. It is actually you.
Oh, it is actually me. Which makes no sense.
You'll be here in a sec.
I hope.
Yeah, I'm just, I'm just feeling like I love the idea of having all these stretch goals and things, but I would hate some of those cool ideas to be lost if we don't hit it. Uh-oh. It's not going to let you connect.
You should probably say it's...
I'll say it's K-pop.
It's the streaming PC of the U-Hub.
Oh, why am I on Wagamama's?
Well, because he just logged in.
Yeah, but I just said Wagamama's, but this is meant to be EU Hub 1 or whatever.
They probably changed the name.
How?
No, they probably changed the name earlier.
Right. It's still a TI4 EU Hub English stream. God damn, what is up? So we're having trouble connecting. First, BTS had a problem connecting, and now we're having a problem connecting. I wonder if there's some maximum limit of people.
No, we haven't reached that yet. We all loaded.
Now, BTS are real loaded. Whoa. Yeah, well.
BTS is tuning to our stream and listening in to counterattack flame back.
We never flamed.
I hope NA Hub is not taking it personally. But they know I'm a joker.
This guy made a really good picture of what Jess would look like if she was Windrunner or Enchantress. You can look this up on Twitter if you look at the hashtag TI4EUHub. That's pretty good Photoshop skills.
I can't even tell it's Jess.
Yeah. Wait, so no, you can't even tell that it's Jess?
No, I can't tell. It doesn't look like Jess.
It does. It looks exactly like Jess.
What?
It looked exactly like Jess. Are you serious? You're crazy.
I need to get your phone next to your face. Okay. Like, hey, don't move for a bit. Let me see.
Okay, we're going to load in. Please leave me. Please leave me.
When you say we, it's not really. Do you know what happened? What did I do before I fall asleep last night?
What did you do? I don't want to say, but what what did you do before you fell asleep last night?
The nerdiest thing. Okay. I had the player's manual on my iPad.
The player's handbook.
Handbook. I was reading it as I fall asleep. That's beautiful. Learned a lot of tips.
Really? About how to be a bard? Well, you ain't going to load into this again, are you? What the hell is going on?
I was reading the skill list and, like, you know, what you should do and stuff like that.
Yeah.
It's very interesting.
Yeah, it is. There's a lot to it.
Supposedly, when you're gathering information, you should give them ale, which is you suggested to me.
I did. Yeah. And did like you do that?
Yes.
Damn it.
I won up that shit. Okay, I don't know what I need to do.
What the hell? Do you need to restart Dota or something?
Yeah, say if it doesn't load, if he could restart. I mean, worst comes to worst, we could go to Dota TV. Last night, I think a couple hours after you left, we had just Fly and Nota on the couch, and we called Dendy.
Oh, really? Yeah, how was he?
Yeah, that's per usual. Everybody's nice. Everybody's funny.
Ooh, son of a bitch.
What happened?
They're going without you, dude. They're fucking just gone.
Oh, shit.
That's nice.
Hmm. I wonder if there's... Well, we have to cast on off the Dota team.
Yeah, okay.
Well, let's see if it loads. Maybe it doesn't
load. If it loads for me, but then you won't be able to see it.
No. Maybe somebody else won't load and have to remake again.
Oh, yeah.
That could happen, right? Game is safe to leave.
Weird.
It's not loading for you now.
No, no, it's not loading for me. It's not us. It's the fucking internet.
Well, we are connecting to a Chinese server, so. Yeah. Which, by the way, fly and no-tail, don't button up your jacket when you're sitting down with coats on.
Yeah, it does that weird thing. So now I can't connect to the server.
I should type the password again. There's a high possibility that they are just remaking.
Best stream? We'll go off Dota TV, I think. We're going to have to. Weird. We were in the lobby. And we both connected, and then one of them couldn't.
Yeah. One of them. I don't know who them was.
I just got to stare at Lifestealer's face on this loading screen. Kind of freaking me out. So what did Dendy have to say for himself?
I was just asking some random questions like...
You were kicked from the lobby by the lobby leader. What the fuck? Do you want to get back in here?
Yeah, oh. I'm kind of stuck. What?
What the fuck? Assholes. They wouldn't even let us in the lobby. Fucking.
Did they just change the password?
No, I was in the lobby. They kicked me out.
Right, and then did they change it afterwards? Is that why you can't join, or did they start it?
No, no. I think they just kicked us out and started the server. But it wasn't our fault. Like, we connected first time, no problem. And
well, we also failed to connect, so. But it's.
Yeah, but it's not specifically us that's the problem, is it?
It's not a nice thing to do.
We're cast off Dota TV, and we're going to shit talk these teams. Even though it isn't their fault.
These lads. So the game that we're casting is LGD versus New Elements.
Okay. Starts in 1 minute.
Yes. LGD is 2-0 right now. And New Element is 2-1. So it actually is one of the best games by standing. Yes, BTS actually paid to have us kicked.
Yeah.
This is definitely true.
Yep. Good call.
Mm-hmm. I'm onto them already. Okay, I can't even connect to the TV.
Just crazy. We're having serious trouble here. To be fair, it's got to go from Sweden all the way to China. So maybe someone's stepping on the cable somewhere halfway across, or it's a hell of a long way.
Ping we had no high. Trouble connecting to sea.
That's true. But it goes under the ocean there a lot, huh?
No.
So you need a crab to come along and snip, snip, snip. I'm going to restart there. Fuck this. Oh, shit.
Oh, no. Oh, I'm in.
But sort only of. In Dota TV, right?
Only Dota TV.
No broadcaster.
Shall we use the Beyond the Summit camera control? Ban. All right, we're going to run the bumper, and we'll be back for the VODs.
Yeah, enjoy this bumper.
Yeah. Hey guys.
Hey.
Long time no see.
Yeah. What you been doing? What you been up to?
Yes. I don't know.
I'm in.
But what we're up to is about to cast some good Dota.
Oh, hell yeah. Can I get a high five on that? Pow.
LGD Gaming on the Radiant side, New Element on the Dire. As we spoke earlier, LGD is 2-0. New Element is 2-1. So some of the real leaders of this particular group stage.
Yep.
And Chinese Dota, to me, actually has been a lot more impressive. Well, I guess none of us has really watched a lot of games, but judging from what Waga's saying, the games are a lot closer.
Yeah.
And from what I've seen, the games are played on a higher skill level as well.
Yeah. I guess there's probably more good Chinese teams, which I think is probably a factor. Sure. So I think we'll see a similar kind of thing maybe with the EU qualifiers as well, where you've got a slightly higher standard. It's a more mature scene, if you like. I don't mean that in any way other than it's an older scene.
Sure.
So the LGD, I mean, look, you know, the bands so far, Batrider, Lycan, and AA and Doom. We see a lot of Doom. So do you think that with the Doom out of the way, we could be looking at an Ember Spirit?
I think so. I just think that Doom shuts down a lot of strategy. Maybe it's just a hero that they just don't want to play against.
Could be.
But I'm surprised to see AA being banned out.
Invoker, there you go. First pick Invoker. This is the kind of Dota I'm more familiar with, Lumi, where people are first picking Invoker if he's not been banned, because he's ridiculous.
Or just playing in a pub and it just gets instant picked, too.
Absolutely. He's insane.
Pyrian is in his element.
I know what I'm talking about now, because I'm familiar with an Invoker first pick. So let's see what they go for now. We've had a disconnect, but he'll be back, I'm sure.
It's not okay, so...
Although it's the captain. Shiki has disconnected.
Yeah, why don't you start the game without him now,
yeah,
huh?
What up there, Shiki, huh?
Why don't you force kick him now?
5 seconds
Unbelievable.
Remaining.
Chinese admins.
Mean.
Also being paid by BTS cash.
They're like, a little bit, they're like, well, you know, you guys didn't load in twice. You're wasting time. Like, well, how about a 116-minute game? That's a waste of time.
It's actually not a waste of time.
Really?
Well,
116 minutes. It wasn't even that many kills. I want kills.
That's my type of games. I like to cast 2.5-hour games. You know?
Wow. Did you? You weren't, were you?
I can't.
Did you cast that one?
That one pub game, I did.
Oh, yeah. No, that was longer than 116 minutes. I love the way the map started to fall apart.
I know. That's the best.
Rubik. Do you know what that was like? The Langoliers. Have you seen that? That Stephen King story?
Is it a movie?
It was a story that became a movie, a really bad B movie.
I've not seen it.
Okay. Where basically some people are on a plane, and I think it gets hit by lightning, or they go through a portal, and they go into the bit of the world that is the like old time.
Okay.
So imagine that the time that we're in now is continually being devoured behind us. So when we leave this time and move, like, as time goes forward, they accidentally got knocked into the past very slightly.
5 seconds remaining.
It's like a limbo. And all the food is stale, and there's no sound,
LGD's
and it's kind of
turn to pick.
Bad. And eventually you get these things called the Langoliers that are like these big sort of, they look like Pac-Man, and they eat the terrain, and they consume reality, and they have to get back through the portal. So it was kind of like
that. Sounds like a good book.
It was, yeah. I mean, it's a really interesting concept. But it was really weird. But anyway, so it was kind of like that. Like watching that game, the world is starting to fall apart. Bits of it are exploding. It makes no sense. Kind of like the Langoliers.
I see.
Slark.
10 seconds remaining.
Yeah, Slark's second pick. I'm very, very surprised to see this hero, at least this highly picked up. Because normally you say, well, because he's very easily shut down, you could draft a couple of heroes to control him very easily.
How can you shut him down? Because I have played a million pub games where he just becomes disgusting. So how do the pros shut him down?
Well, the key thing to prevent a Slark from going completely out of control is actually protecting your tier 1 towers.
Okay.
Because when a Slark on the enemy side has a boot upgrade, like a Treads, and your support, like a CM, has basic brutes,
right,
she runs up at you and kills you.
Okay.
also, Slark is not exactly the best mid-game hero once you're starting to group up. Because his two best build is BKB or Shadowblade. So he could jump into a group of five and you just right-click him, he's dead.
If he is
using invisibility, you just drop Sentry when you're pushing as five, right, and he really can't do as much. I think he's really powerful in pub games because nobody defends tier one, so he gets a big surge of gold, he can pick out supports. And no, even when you're pushing S5, there is really good detection, good enough detection.
Yeah,
so he gets to do whatever he wants to do.
Like he seems to me like the ultimate sort of Regoose hero.
Yes.
Like he goes in, he kills somebody or messes him up, runs away a bit, regens, comes back in for the Regoose. Like a lot of the time, one of the things I really like about him is you know where the enemy's warded, right? Like that's quite handy. There's stuff because he doesn't regen when there's wards around, so you can easily deward. That's kind of a nice little touch that he's got. He is great at picking heroes off, locking them, like getting that pounce. Dark Pact doesn't get revealed by sentries or dust or anything like that, so he is still relatively hard to catch. But
yes, There is a hero that could reveal him, which is Void, and I think that's actually a matchup we saw yesterday.
He gets revealed in Chronosphere?
Yes. I think Chronosphere is the only spell that reveals it.
Yeah.
And the strange thing was, Void was picked, and then the other team picked Slark into the Void.
Oh, man.
And proceeded to GG out in like 25 minutes, because the Void was just like killing everything. But in any case, with the Invoker and Dragon I picked up, those are two core heroes.
Yeah, this fucking thing is driving me up the wall. Sorry, it's stuck on...
No problem, as Ted is fixing his mic. Yeah, we glass wearers have it hard.
Yeah, it's
when
not
we
easy.
Wear these mics.
Reserve time.
There we go.
But we have a couple Dire more bans being taken ban. Out. I imagine we're going to see a mid DK and a safe lane Invoker.
Okay. Why? I mean, don't you think the Dragonite benefits more from the farm, or do you think Invoker benefits more from the farm?
They actually both need quite a bit of farm.
Yeah.
And quite a bit of experience. Invokers and DK, I suppose, both of those heroes are fairly self-sufficient. So if your support decides to pull or roam away, they could just still man the lane very well. And now with the Darkseer being picked up, you probably want Invoker as a range matchup against Darkseer.
Definitely, yeah.
Than a DK eating those iron shells.
Absolutely. So, I mean, is Dazzle particularly good as a roaming support, do you think, or not? I mean, if you paired him with someone that has a stun, you know...
He's actually pretty bad.
Yeah. So that says to me that they're going to put, like, Invoker safe lane with a support or two, maybe someone in the jungle.
Yeah, and they might actually play it very passively.
Yeah.
Like, Darkseer is going to come out and punch Darkseer quite a bit with his
LGD's
range attack.
This lineup. Look at this lineup. Rubick, Slark, Darkseer, Tree. Kind of unusual.
It is unusual in the sense that you don't really have good damage on demand.
Yeah.
Like, you don't have, for example, a Meteor and a Flame Breath just to knock the HP off of people. So I really think that new elements need to survive for a long time in these team fights, which they can because they have spells like Leech Seed, Living Armor, Surge, and all that kind of stuff.
Dire
and a Slark. If the
team
fight gets very long, the Slark could get out of control. But I think LG Gaming has a different idea. They're going to go offensive trialing with the Pugna.
Yeah.
LGD's turn to
ban. So Dragon Knight mid, Invoker safe, Pugna Dazzle, and one other in an aggressive trilane.
Yeah.
Shut down the Slark.
I'm not sure if the Slark's going to be there. I think this
could
be
Slark mid, maybe?
Yeah, a very decent solo mid Slark in the game. Because
he's up against DK.
Yeah,
so,
and you actually could get a point to the Essence Aura, Essence Shift.
Remaining.
Yeah.
And just, like, trade hits.
Sounds good. They've got the tree. I mean, it's interesting, picking the Pugna into tree, because you know you're going to get tree armor on the towers and things like that. So
yeah, that's a great point.
Are they picking him as a sort of pushing Pugna, or...?
I mean, is there a non-pushing Pugna?
Yeah, it's just...
It's just the one thing, right?
I guess, like, his Nether Ward is going to be quite nice against Darkseer, because his spells are quite expensive, I guess. I don't really understand
it. I'm not really sold on this pick, but
no.
I guess LGD could show us why. We do know this push this lineup could push extremely well, because DK, once he hits 6, he's PPing on your towers. Invoker, once he gets double Force Spirit, same thing.
Yeah.
Then. So
and Dazzle can heal up the creeps and keep the push
going,
right?
Like so. It's not something like a hardcore push like a Chen, Enigma, that kind of stuff.
Yeah.
But it's going to knock down a couple of towers.
I mean, Invoker, DK, Pugna, that's pretty strong. Especially because they've got room in the lineup now to pick up a Chen. Maybe if he goes aggressive try, he could get up all in the enemy's jungle. They could get a Chen. Or that Enchantress you were talking about. Chen's been banned, actually. They could get an Enchantress here and go aggressive try like you were talking about. She's fine in the offlane. Witch Doctor.
Okay, they're just healing up their creep wave,
I guess. One of my favorite heroes. I bloody love Witch Doctor.
He's so good. I think he should be picked more.
Puppy hates him.
Why is that?
He said he's a garbage hero. I played a pub game with him, and he was like, oh my god, you picked Witch Doctor? Why? I said, he owns.
Yeah.
He's so much fun. He's like, garbage, just garbage hero. Pick Venomancer. What do you do? And I was like, whoa. It's weird. Venomancer was like number one support pick for a while.
He was. He was. And Crystal Maiden was up there as well.
Yeah, yeah.
Where are those two heroes now?
Yeah.
Sad to see them go. But I think this is actually a one-roll Slark.
Remember the overlays now, Lumi.
I got it. It's already there.
You got to turn it off, though. Oh, see, you've already turned it off. No.
That's the metagame.
That's how you do it. You turn it off early.
Right after
Ten
the drafting.
Seconds
nice.
Remaining.
And then I don't worry
nice.
About it.
Nice. So we're going to have Tiger on the
Five
Darks here.
Seconds remaining.
Katy Perry DJ, or Dire Straits DJ on the Slark. The Answer on Rubick. Who else are we going to have up here? Maples on the tree. I like the fact like maple syrup comes from a tree.
Yeah.
That makes sense. And Shiki on the Nyx Assassin.
Yep.
Who have we got on the Radiant side?
So we got Taobao. No, Taobao's the sponsor. Yao playing Pugna. Rabbit playing Dragonite. Rabbit, or known as xiaotuji, for those of you guys that are following a little bit older Dota. We have Lin playing Invoker. DDC handling Dazzle. And then DD. So playing the Witch Doctor. We're going to get confused between DDC and DD.
We surely are. But
actually the same player.
That's some Michael skills right there.
So actually Brutes first on Invoker. That's pretty curious. I guess he's saying that I'm going to go Exhort anyways. I have a lot of base damage. I could get a couple of assets. I just don't want to deal with the Iron Shell with the creeps coming in.
Or yeah.
He's expecting a offensive Trialing, which
it's he's exactly going to get, I think. Yeah. Either that or they're just going to go ward up the jungle here, but yeah, interesting. I think it's going to be Darkseer safe. Look at this. So he's going to go into the aggressive try. Would actually be quite difficult for them to kill him with that surge. They've got the bongos stun and the... Yeah, I think that Darkseer is going to be absolutely fine here.
Yeah, I think it's mostly going to be pushing his tower instead of killing him.
Yeah, push the tower and get out of the lane, right?
But the problem is, like, level 1 Nether Blast is not exactly the best thing, because only 100 damage. So at that point, the Iron Shell creep could actually whittle down the creep wave a little bit. But I guess that's what where the Dazzle comes in and Shadow Waves and heals everything up.
Yeah.
So I think the top is going to just tray hits for a while. I think the Radiant Jungle, or sorry, the Radiant Trilane is going to abuse the pull on the left side and then try to cut a little bit of Syrians off the Darkseer. I'm just actually really worried about this trialing on the bottom, because if they don't get a lot of kills, this tree is going to have a little bit of problem getting experience.
Yeah, also the Slark will have been stuck in a trialing for literally no reason.
Mm-hmm.
And he benefits quite well from having levels and stuff, doesn't he?
Yeah, you want to get him a couple levels higher than the enemy support.
Definitely.
Because ideally the goal with this hero is to run in, kill support, and then run back
get
out.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, the thing is, like, Witch Doctor... and Pugna and Dazzle are all legitimate targets for a Slark, I think. Especially if he gets like a Basher or something like that. Get a Bash off on that Dazzle before he can Shallow Grave, and even just then, just chase him down. I mean, Witch Doctor, it's a nightmare playing against someone like Slark when you're a Witch Doctor. If you can't get that Bongo off, and he can always Dark Pact if you do throw it, right?
Does that come from personal experience, Furion?
Maybe.
Your Witch Doctor against those damn Slark pickers.
It's horrible.
No, I hear you, man.
It sucks.
Slark Picker is the worst.
Yeah. Oh, and they're rotating. So they're going to go and go bot. They're going to say, hey, guys, look, they just stuck the Darkseer here. Come bot, please help. So Dazzle and Witch Doctor, they look like a couple of guys that hang out together anyway. Look at Dazzle and Witch Doctor. They have a lot in common, these guys.
Actually friends.
Yeah. Should be best friends. And they're going to be up against the Rubick Treant Slark combo.
Yeah, so Treian is actually fairly dangerous to zone out, because he could always turn around and leech seed and start punching you.
Yeah,
he does so much damage, so you gotta be afraid.
87, that has to be the highest starting attack damage in the game.
Yeah, that actually is.
But I'll tell you what, man, Spirit Breaker isn't far behind that. Spirit Breaker has like 700 and something. Like, if you start the game with Spirit Breaker and you buy a couple of branches and get an urn early on, you become an absolute monster in the early game.
He does have the insane really base stats, and I think when he was picked support for the same reason as Treant support, why he's so effective.
Right.
You just run up to people. But looks like they're going to make a go here on DD, and DD's going to have a very big trouble surviving. Those bongo casts is bouncing, but not really on the right side, and with Slark and Treant pouncing, like, no.
They got him right in that creep wave too, so the bongos... The chance of bouncing to a creep was pretty high, I think. But he just couldn't move quickly as well. This is the other thing. He's 3 or 5 move speed is fine, but not enough to get away. That's why sometimes, like, you sometimes see people, like, get boots on Sand King first, because otherwise he's hella slow. And I do sometimes wonder as Witch Doctor whether it's I need boots, because I always get jumped.
Well, and Lin is going to get tossed back. Actually, 305 for a support, that's better than CM.
It is, yeah,
say.
It is. It's super quick. They might get this Rubick, but... if only he could have thrown a cask, but of course he couldn't. It's on cooldown, but...
Yeah, living
Rubick
armor
will
came in.
Living armor, man. They're going to find it really hard to get a pick off here. Like, the Rubick lift into Pounce, into the Leech Seed, is really pretty strong.
Actually, they're not even going for pickoff at all. If you look at the invoker, his second point is to exhort. Like, forget invoke. I'm just going to get last hits.
Yeah.
Yeah, which I think is about right. Especially when you gave up the first blood in that lane, they're going to be much stronger because they have the extra gold to work with. And then you're kind of just sitting duck. So just go for the last hits. Maybe allow your support to go for the pull, which is what Dazzle is doing right now. And they're going to try to slowly catch back up in terms of experience.
Pugna's having a great time up here against Darkseer, though. He's leading the way for farm.
Yep. Try again.
It's not too bad, though. Darkseer's, you know, doing fine as well.
The other thing is, like, if Darkseer tries to Ion Shell up and chase him down, he can always decrep him, buy himself a little bit of time. He's got those boots nice and early. He moves hella fast, Pugna. 370.
Well, he doesn't have a lot of health to begin with. And here comes a gank on the mid lane. The courier's coming in as well. Xiaotuji, he's going to get lifted up. He's going to get tossed back. Leech Seed and the double damage on Shiki. The stun goes on. He does have the magic bottle. Should be slower to spamming it. And he will actually survive the gank.
Whoa.
Nicely done.
I thought the DD on Nyx would have been enough. They just couldn't get a punch on him. Like, a punch was... he had, I guess, one charges. He must have had a lot of one charges. Because he popped him and got a lot of health back.
Well, it would have been enough if the bottle didn't came in the end as well. So
that's handy.
Pretty close call. All right, I guess we're going to see some musical chair from the supports because now they're rotating back up top. New Elements is actually doing quite well because the primary concern for me is that whether they're going to get good experience on the supports because ideally you want to hit six on both these supports very quickly.
Mm. Definitely. Cold Snap. Invoked by Invoker.
Hide.
Just giving some guff to Slark.
This lane actually can't kill the Slark at all, though.
Yeah.
Because Cold Snap, you could Dark Pack or jump out of it. Cast is not exactly the most reliable spell. Maybe that's why Poppy hates the hero.
I'm really, really... I'll be honest with you, I'm really surprised that he hasn't taken the Maledict. Because if you get a Bongo into, like, Maledict and Cold Snap, you could do enough damage so that he might pop. And I'm not sure that you need the heal, like... It costs 8 mana per second for 16 health per second. It's not particularly good at level 1, I don't think.
Yeah.
Especially when Invoker's fine, really.
It's actually not one of the better heals in the game, but I think he took the heal for the same reason that Invoker took Invoke at level took the Exhort at level 2.
Yeah.
They just actually don't plan to kill. So, also, I think...
Slark can purge the Maledict as well, can't he?
Or just jump away and not take more damage. I think also is because they're picking Woodchucker for a little bit more push and to heal.
Yeah,
and,
so get the heal leveled up. Yeah,
right,
that makes sense.
And he knows he can actually get to like level 16 and max out all his spells. So
of course, yeah.
Every point that you skip right now is pretty important down the drain.
And now Pugna's down here, Nether Blast, and they're going to try and get this tower. Forge Spirit as well. Is there going to be a rotation to save it? Darkseer's here, Rubick is here, but that's it.
Yeah.
They're going to do a lot of damage to this tower.
I think they're going to actually just kill the tower straight up because Yao has a ton of mana left. He has three more blasts. And here comes the Darkseer creep, but again, the cast is going to just null down the creep.
And that Nether Blast, too. Really good. Getting the tower. That's the best thing about Pugna's Nether Blast is you can guarantee yourself the last hit on the tower.
Yeah.
He does. I wonder if he'll get an Ags. I love getting an Ags on Pugna. I think his ult is really good in a team fight.
I think with his big surge of gold, he might start with like a mech for the team.
Oh yeah, totally.
And then maybe actually go back into X. Because not only does it improve your ultimate, but quite a bit. Look at DK.
Whoa, DK's up here.
Yeah, just coming out of nowhere. Just suddenly a five-man push. We're 6 minutes in the game.
Yeah. This is the opposite of the Chinese Dota I was promised with that 116-minute game that we had earlier.
It's like 160 or 20, period. Which side of the fence are you on?
I would like a 20-minute game. That would be cool. Could go and get some lunch.
I think the cool thing about this kind of playstyle from LGD is you're not exactly doing a suicidal push.
No.
Like, if this doesn't work, you're like, well, we're going to back off farm for a couple more minutes and try again maybe on the mid lane.
Definitely.
Yeah. And
especially because I think, like, this works for them both ways because who is farming for NE? I mean, the tree is just standing there. He can tree armor from across the map. So it's just given the Slark some farm. Yep. But it's not like he's pushing towers. They can always go and rotate. And like you were saying, Slark likes to get those early towers. If they can get this entire lane of towers and then rotate mid, then they can start getting Roche, and they can really start putting some pressure on NE.
I think that's what's going to be planned. Here comes that tier 2 tower. They'll destroy. The cast going to fly off. Another thing they can do is just go back to their respective lanes, push it back out a little bit, get some experience. Because if you're pushing S5, one thing that you do worry about is your experience growth.
Yeah.
Since you're stacking up with each other. So
definitely.
quickly peek over at the AXP earn, and it's actually new elements that's leading, and you know that should be expected because constantly it's the same grouping up from LGD.
Did you see the it was the game that me and Shane cast where it was Orange, I think, against Myth. I want to say Myth, one of the playoff games for the C three-way tie, and they had to win in under 48 minutes.
Yeah, yeah, right? I saw that game.
And
you guys were really riled up in that game because it was, you know, it was pushing against time, and they were always on the back foot.
They were, but like we kept wondering, okay, they need to beat a time, but it's not like they needed to beat 25 minutes.
No.
I mean, 40, you know, whatever, nearly 50 minutes. You don't necessarily need to pick such a gimped lineup and just go five-man from the start.
Yeah, I think they got like a Chen Juggernaut roster, right? Like, it was just nothing but pushing
right.
heroes.
It was just, let's push and we'll never stop. And it was kind of like, okay, but they had a Morana who just farmed. And who was the other hero they had that just farmed? I can't remember. Oh, Tao, okay.
Dragonite. He's
the like the, I think they almost sacrificed any sense of a plan B.
Yeah.
They just said, no, if this doesn't work, well, we're completely boned. And that's exactly what happened. It didn't work. And they didn't get the push they wanted. It was really hard. Dragonite popping his ult, and they're going to try and get this tier 2 mid. And just like I suspected.
Yeah,
get that pressure
on there.
Get that Roche on the like DK or the Invoker.
Ooh, here comes the Slarkish.
Yeah, trouble.
Careful. The Pounce is going to come, and they're going to go on DK, who is actually the tankiest member. He does have eight magic wandstick, and here comes the big wall dropping on everybody. Impel hits on xiaotuji, but he's still tanked up. I mean, I think that's actually the heal coming from Witch
Doctor. Yeah, big time.
It might
Dazzle
not be good at level 1, but it's really good now.
Definitely. The wall not really doing a huge amount. It's early levels, and they didn't get the stun. The way his movement there was really good. He could see the stun was coming in from the Nyx, so he turned and ran south, and then he just ran into the middle of all four of them.
Yeah.
Didn't give a fuck. In comes the Witch Doctor Cask, messes things up for everybody. If he'd been level 6 there, that would have been time to dance.
Yeah, I really like the way that LGD has been playing right now. They got the two tower, they rotated mid, like you said, but they left the Invoker bottom because they know that he needs double force spirit.
Absolutely.
ASAP. He'll get it because
he's got his Midas too. He has
exactly.
a Midas and treads now, so it's like, great, you've given me enough time. Now I can definitely get my levels and my farm on, and I'm a happy man.
And then if you look over to Yao on his Pugna, he's got that mech. So we have even more healing. So
definitely.
You now have a Shadow Wave that's being leveled up, I presume. You have a Witch Doctor Voodoo Restoration, which is a ton of healing, and then a mech on top of that. Now, granted, you do have a Nyx Assassin that can be mana burning away, and I think mana burn is actually a big deal in this game, because mana,
Radiant's
when you're trying to sustain a push,
is
literally the most important thing.
Absolutely. But you've got a lot of Mana Boots carriers, I think, here.
Yes.
Witch Doctor, you've got Pugna as well. Dazzle could get Mana Boots too. So I think you've got the potential there to sustain through that mana burn. And of course, you've got EMP. You can always dump EMP and you know, or Tornado, cancel a fight if things go wrong. So it's going to be, I think, it's only 1-0 at 10 minutes. But they've already taken 3 towers. Shall we look at some graphs? Gold graphs. They're up by 4K. XP, well, they're down. So that's the only by less than 1,000, though. So not the end of the world.
Yeah, it's not the biggest deal, especially that we're only 10 minutes into the game. And you said that Arcane Boots good. And normally, a lot of supports want to get Arcane Boots. But normally, they don't have to go for it, right? But
right.
game, you're pushing 4 towers now. This is going to be the 4th tower down in 10 minutes. You're going to have to go for the
Absolutely. Earn up on Witch Doctor. I think that's good. I might get an N on Witch Doctor. I
All
like
right.
that.
It's going to be a massive TP going to bottom here. Lin's going to get Grave. He's going to drop a Sunstrike before leaving out of there. Shiki tanks most of it. The Sun's going to come through. Shiki is actually going to go down. Or will he? He's going to try to go for a kill. But Lin, again, getting healed up. Look at the insane healing. The Answer is trying to right click. But he's only a Rubick. Meanwhile, Tiger's going for the kill. He wants to get the Voodoo Restoration.
That Witch Doctor, man. I take it back. Running around with that heal on. That is nice. All he did was just chase after whoever was low, say, get in my magic circle, and you'll be fine.
And not only that, though, because he was there for 3 kills, his urn is being filled up.
Right.
So that's going to help the next push. Invoker says thank you for the experience.
And he has 1,000 gold now, so there's his mana boots. Witch Doctor is a happy man.
I think this is the reason why you don't second pick Slark, because it really leaves you vulnerable. Slark, to me, is one of those... like, we talked about how Orange played is a very single mindset hero.
Mm.
He's very good at doing that one thing, but he generally just does one thing only, which is run around the map and kill stuff. But when they are taking the fight to you, with a stronger fighting lineup and pushing lineup, it's really hard for Slark to play well and have a big impact.
Yeah, he needs to be able to, like, I think that if, like, for instance, you'd picked Slark and they had a CM and she was doing the jungle, oh, this courier could be in trouble. No, it just go. By the way, look at this courier that the Dire team have. What the hell is that? I've never seen that before.
That is a Chinese zombie.
Wow.
So the Western zombie is this, like, ghoul-looking thing that has, like, you know, bones, skeleton, and pilcher blood. The Chinese zombie jumps with arms sticking out.
He looks more like Napoleon. Tiny Napoleon.
Well, maybe that is how we
maybe
got the Chinese zombie.
Come around the back is Nyx Assassin. I think he's waiting in the wings. And along with Darkseer, gets the Ion Shell up on him.
Uh-oh.
Can he do anything here?
Yeah.
The Bongo bounces to Roshan, back to Nyx.
And it's
bouncing,
around.
Between. They get the wall down. They manage to get DK in the wall. And there goes the Witch Doctor. Oh, the bash on Darkseer. Almost left Darkseer stuck in trouble there. But Sunstrike coming down as well. DK goes right back through the wall. He doesn't give a hoot. And they're going to chase down this magic cloud of Slark. Try and get him. He's been slowed. Decrep? No. Netherblast.
There's a stun. Yeah, there's a stun.
There it is.
In. But he's not going to debuff
one
it.
More. Oh, he lives. He's on 77
oh
health.
God.
Unbelievable.
And his Star Pack is regening against the poison, so he's going to survive.
That is the power of the Slark in a game where he can come and go.
Right.
But here, they're having to fight around their towers and defend all the time on the back foot. I was just going to say, in a game where you would have had, like, Crystal Maiden in the jungle, then you would have been worried about the Slark getting in there, getting an easy kill. But here it's like, well, you can't really fight into five of us. You're not going to pick anybody off. So, yeah, really tough.
Yeah, I also want to point out that Rabbit on his mid DK has actually maxed Dragon Blood first.
Yeah.
Which is, you know.
That's sustained, though. Right?
It is sustained. And I just want to point out that this is not the correct build to do in your pub games. Unless, you know, in some very specific circumstance. And this is one of those.
You get that Breathe Fire up, right?
I mean, you want to max the Breathe Fire because that's your main farming spell. That's
Radiant's
how you kill people. That's how you harass. But this game, I mean, the reason that he was able to withstand in the front line for such a long time and take advantage of his team's heals because of that 8 extra armor. Yeah, 12 extra armor. Jeez, I thought it was just 8 armor. It gave you so much.
Crazy, isn't it?
Yeah.
I mean, his Elder Dragon form, every time it's on cooldown, he just pops it, walks up there, and just does a ton of damage to the tower along. And then behind them all, you've got the heals coming in from Witch Doctor. Him and Pugna between them, with the Forge Spirits, do enough damage to just melt these towers.
Yeah, and here comes that tier 2 without any kind of fight. I guess the fight previously were new elements.
Radiant's
basically used all of their spells.
Yeah.
It all went down. And here comes the push.
Straight up.
Yeah.
Do you know what? This is funny because in that game, the orange game where they had to push, they had Shadow Shaman, right?
Yep.
And I mean, if they picked this lineup, the LGD lineup, I think it would have gone a lot better for them because the problem with the Shadow Shaman was that you knew the timing of when they were going to push.
Yeah.
It's like, okay, whenever his wards are up, they're going to fight because they literally couldn't do it otherwise.
Didn't they have a Krobulus as well?
Yeah, they did. They did. So they just knew the timing of when they were going to push. And the problem was that all they had to do, he'd walk up and pop the wards, but he was so underleveled and so underfarmed that basically they just turn around and just nuke his wards down and then be like, what do you got? Like,
yep.
It was really cold.
The big difference between that push, which features Shadow Shaman as well as Krobulus, is that those ultimates are very strong in their own right. But if you outlast them, which is either kill the wards or wait out the ghosts,
right.
you defend it.
Absolutely.
And the enemy team just have to back off because there's really no way for them to fight. And correct me if I'm wrong, I think the other team had a tree in that game as well. Every time,
I think you might be right.
Yeah,
I think
every
so.
Time you repel the push, the Treant would just heal the tower up.
Yeah.
And this is the strength of this LGD lineup, because they never leave a tower half dead. They just go all the way. So here comes a gank.
Oh, this could be something. This is what they've been waiting for, is the chance to gank somebody.
Yeah, but he's running towards his team. He's actually fairly tanky at this point as well. So yeah, back to this draft is that the Treant in this game never really gets to do what he wants to do the most, which is heal up his towers. Normally that's very good against a pushing strat, but again, if the tower is just constantly dead, then there's nothing to heal up.
Yeah, I think we had a misclick from Rabbit. He's used his BKB. I can't think what it was for.
That would suck. Yeah.
But
it's okay. It's you still have 4 points Dragon Blood.
Yeah.
Just walk
he's,
it off.
He's okay. He's still got 18 armor.
Yeah.
So crazy.
And like, I think that tier 2 is the last tower that's going to be going down.
If you think about what kind of level of regen he's got, you've got his health regen of 5, armor of 12. And whatever one charges he gets, plus his 7.2 regen from that. Then you've got the Witch Doctor heal, which is at level 3. So that's 32 health per second. Ooh,
they want to fight on this. Answer gets initiated. Sunstrike's going to come through. Look at his HP, but a really nice impel from the side. But yes, back to the math about regen, because I'm actually very curious about this as well.
Okay, so then you've got the Dazzle heal from the Shadow Wave as well, healing them up. It's 120 on an 8-second cooldown, soon to be a 6-second cooldown. Yeah. I have no idea what the actual DPS that he could tank would be, but it's a hell of a lot. And a mech, yeah, it's ridiculous.
So, yep. Here we go. They're not even bothering with that synergy top. They're going to just go for it. And normally, if you have a hero like Nature's Prophet, you could like nick a tier 1 tower or two. And they're trying that. If you look at Darkseer, he's creep skipping. If you look at Slark, he's trying to split push. But
right.
It's just not fast enough.
No. You're not gonna be able to sort of pressure them by doing that, I don't think.
Look at this zapping ward action.
That zap. Yeah, it's kind of stupid. It doesn't actually hurt too much. Oh, this could be bad. The Treant into the Darkseer wall. Gets a good few of them. The Shallow Grave on the Invoker. I think Rubik stole Cask, which kind of messed things up for them there. The Witch Doctor and the Invoker both die. They're going to chase down the Pugner, and he is going to be a dead goose.
Ooh, that's already dangerous. Has three kills coming out for new element, excuse me. And I'm not sure, because a lot of pushing lineup, they have this momentum, right? Once you lose that first fight, you're like, oh, I'm kind of scared. You come back for the second push, and maybe you get the racks, but you lose another big fight. And that could be the beginning of a comeback. I really think the reason that New Element won that fight is because of the Rubik.
Absolutely.
First, he stole the Nether Ward, which constantly zapped and did a ton of damage against LGD. Secondly, like you pointed out, he stole the Cask, which stunned everybody.
That was big. And that gave the chance for the Treant ult, the Vacuum Wall, and that really did turn things around for them. Mm-hmm. And they're going to get their third tower of the game.
Well, they're TPing back in right now, and actually, it's going to be New Element that runs away. Lin's going to come in. The cast is going on Maples. Maple takes a big Sunstrike, but the mech's through, so they could heal back up. I think if you're Lin... And
DK, look at this. He wants this tree. He's all over it. The Nether Blast too. There goes the Treant ult. He might be able to escape. I think they've got him. Yeah. The slow from Dazzle. They drop a ward. There you go. They're going to give him one. The tree jukes. He's out. He must have been just out of range of that sentry. He was. The sentry just out of range. Crazy.
And they didn't have another sentry. That's kind of a big deal because as he's walking back, he can heal up whatever tower he has left. No, he doesn't have any tower.
Yeah, the tower's gone. Yeah, that would have been a big deal.
So he would just heal himself back up, I guess. But Dyer's having him alive means the push is going to be slowed down because, again, he could living armor the range rack, for
definitely.
Example.
These double Dyer's forge spirits, man, they are just death for structures. In goes the Slark, manages to get the Nether Ward. The stolen Bongos goes back down again on DK, but that regen and the healing, he's fully back up to full health. The wall goes down, but they can just wait this out. And now I think, where are they? Are they going to go? They might go get Roshan, maybe?
No, they have to back off because they have no more Sentry Ward.
Slark
running in and out, the Nyx Assassin running in and out. And again, it's a battle of attrition to me. If you are NE and if you can outlast this push via things like Living Armor, via things like constant mana burn, then you're going to be okay. Also, in a similar vein to Shadow Shaman as well as Exorcism, once DK form runs out, you know, again, he's much weaker as a hero. So we'll see if Rabbit decides to hold the push until his next dragon form comes out.
Darkseer actually has quite a bit of money here. He's got 2.5 grand, and he has the Ogre Club already. So, I mean, I think if he goes Ags here, which wouldn't be bad, I quite like Ags on Darkseer.
Or maybe BKB, because it gives him the ability to run in and get off a very good vacuum.
Yep.
And set up things for Slark. So
I kind of feel like with the Treant ult and with the like a good stun from Nyx, it's not necessary to really worry too much. But they have got quite a few. I mean, you've got the Dragon Tail is such a good stun if you run in. And you're going to want to get the Darkseer in there, the Dragon Knight, so you know that you're going to have to run up next to him. If he BKBs and gives you a bit of a Dragon Tail, then you could be in trouble.
Yeah, regardless of what the Darkseer gets, the key thing is he's getting more HP, which allows him to withstand and stay in the front line.
He's like a tough peanut, like a really tough peanut.
I think NE has actually hit their timing, which is BKB on a Slark. Now he gets to jump in, and it's actually he is at a stage where he can't get right-click down anymore because with 6 armor, a drums, and a poor man's shield, he'll go in your support, and it's very hard for DK at this stage of the game to right-click the Stark and kill him. So I think LGD, their steam is actually slowed and stopped.
Yeah, that's twice that they've had to back off. The DK goes top to push this out and get some farm on, and this is what NE need, is just a little bit of time, push the lanes out, because they know that if LGD try to come up those steps, they're going to be walking up into wall, they're going to be walking up into Treant ult and all the all kinds of stuff like that. So I wonder if LGD are just going to say, okay, let's take a minute, get a couple more items, and then we'll try again.
Yeah, or maybe they could go for the long run. Pyrian, who do you think has a better late game? Just looking at, like, forget about who has a 5-0
okay,
goal lead.
Right, just look
at the draft and who has a better late game.
Well, I think that the thing with Witch Doctor and Dazzle is that they're really good, but in a late game, they just get exploded by someone like Nyx. If he gets, like a Dagon or something like that, mm-hmm. then I think that would really suck for someone like Witch Doctor. So he would not be a factor. If Slark can get really, really big, I know a lot of people... when I was at TI3, I was talking about him, and people were saying, oh yeah, he could be an amazing carry, and there were a lot of people discussing how they would make it work and stuff. He can become really, really disgusting if he gets that sort of early good start and snowball, but I mean, I don't know, it's tough. I really do like LGD's lineup.
Here comes Dragon, he's gonna pop that BKB, he's looking for that vacuum, there's a vacuum only on the two. The blink stump here from Sheiky, not gonna connect though. Meanwhile on the front line here, it's gonna be DK tanking everybody up. The BKB gets active, where's the Slark? I need him to be running on the back line here. DJ runs in, he tops it, but he's dead. I think that's a huge deal because he has no buyback at this point. Dragon is gonna get blown up by that death where we might not see the late game because I think LGD has enough to go through. The only thing that's going for NE is that if you look at the mana for Pugna, he doesn't have much.
Yeah.
So he's almost out of tank, but he has a good two more blasts. And when you have five heroes surviving, I don't think you need really Pugna's blast at this point. They could rotate to the bottom and start taking towers as well.
Yeah, that was a really, really bad fight for NE. The Slark got picked off. Like
he didn't activate his Tesenga BKB.
Yeah.
I'm not sure what that was about.
It's not great. I mean, they've lost an entire out, so they're going to lose probably another one here. I mean, the push potential, actually, they're going to have to back down.
I guess Slark just got enough blow to buy back?
Yeah, I guess. Yeah,
but
he did just
buy back. They're like, okay, we'll just back off now.
But they got the whole mid lane. But anyway, regarding the late game, I do think the DK Invoker is better late game than what any have.
I agree. So I think LGD just have a superior draft, right?
Yeah.
They're able to execute a fast early game push to win the game early. And if it
doesn't shut down the Slark as But then, I mean, you got your Hyperstone and DK. He is a major problem in these fights for them. He's so tanky, and he does deal a lot of damage to the Flame Breath. I mean, Breathe Fire, sorry, that's doing 300. He hits pretty hard as well. Gets a Hyperstone, get that attack speed up. What items do you get on him? I mean, AC, obviously. But he is still, these are sort of fairly defensive items. Can you ever build him as just a right clicker, or do you just get in that dragon form and do that instead?
Oh yeah, you definitely could build him right click. Like if you go for a Shadow Blade Maelstrom, that kind of build, and just get nothing but attack speed, you have so much damage because you have a splash attack.
Right.
You just go to work.
And you've got that natural tank from the dragon's blood, right?
You're a strength hero at heart, so you know you can just go for just right damage, right click damage.
Yeah.
But I think this game AC gives him. Let's not forget that AC is attack speed and minus armor.
Absolutely. Yeah.
So
yeah.
It really helps that siege.
I think it's a great item to get here. I do, because he knows that he's going to be the focus. Like if they kill the DK, they have to run.
And I think NE is going to come for maybe like a game-turning fight in their minds.
NE need this. Yeah. They need something here. Drop the DK quick.
Overgrowth, that's going to hit on everybody. Where's the vacuum, though? Vacuum's not there. They drop the vacuum. They drop the wall. It's a chaotic team fight. But look at the Dragonite. He's on the front line, and he's just right-clicking away. On the back line, Witch Doctor is channeling his ultimate. The bongos are bouncing left and right. And you have a Slark that's trying to right-click for everything, but he just doesn't do enough damage to kill things quickly enough. And it's going to be run the other direction. The Slark is probably going to survive. But the big problem is you haven't killed anybody, you haven't expended their momentum or mana, and LGD's coming for the jugular.
And look, they've got now the Neckbook creeps, they've got the Forge Spirits, you've got the Dragon Form is still up for a good long time, but this is a whole nother lane of racks. Slark just running in there, trying to distract them. I think that the problem they have is that even if they land the Treant ult, there isn't some massive AoE thing
to
splash over them. Yeah, it's a big problem. I mean, you get the wall off, that's great, but it's not the same.
Yeah. The wall is really good in this game because you do get a DK illusion, which does splash. But at the same time, ooh, nice impale coming out. At the same time, DK could just right-click those illusions and kill them in two-shot.
Yeah. They've also, you know that in the middle of the fight, you're going to be up against the Forge Spirits, the Neckbook creeps, the creeps, all the other push that they've got as well. So if you don't win, you're in trouble.
Yeah.
There goes the overgrowth again. But DK's like, that's cool. I've got full health.
They might lose the DD, the Witch Doctor, but like...
Nah, they should turn around and kill the Slark here. I think they've got the potential. Nice dodge on the stun there.
Yep, here comes Dragon again using that vacuum, but no wall to fall up this time here. And Dragon, I sitting on the front line. He is the warrior.
He really is. Yeah. He's just the front line, swinging it. He's the paladin in this party.
Well, the paladin in our party almost died yesterday, so I'm just...
and the moment she got in a fight was like, right, I'm running.
Well, the monk is the slug this game, right? Like, I mean, he just jumps into five and hope for the best. But I guess this monk is a little harder to hit.
Definitely.
But in any case, I think we're going to see LGD regroup, maybe heal up, spend their gold, and just go up top.
The other thing to remember is that in all of this, the Pugner is just kind of chilling.
Yeah.
Like, drops his nether ward, mechs if needed, decreps somebody, nether blasts, and uses his ult and stuff. He's just like, he doesn't seem to be the focus at all. They're all trying to kill the DK. They're trying to kill the Witch Doctor.
There's just too many stuff you need to kill.
Yeah, that's the problem.
Witch Doctor cast, what is it? It's 40 HP a second? Just like, imagine that you have a hero that has a 40 HP regen per second.
Right.
Like, that is kind of ridiculous.
Yeah, on top of Dragon Knight's, what is it, plus 7, so 47 per second. Plus the heal from Dazzle, plus the mech from Pugna. Yeah, it's crazy. And there's a mid tower denied.
Middle tower,
so they've almost got two full lanes. The range barracks is all that's left, but they got mid, and now they're going to, I guess, rotate around and just push the hell out of this one.
Yeah, I mean, at this point, if you're any, you just try to prevent the inevitable as long as you want, and hopefully that you can find a good fight. But it's hard to find it, because... Let's say that instead of a Dragon Knight, LGD has a Wraith King, a Wraith Knight, which is a very common hero, common core hero we see. A lot of lineup could just perhaps run past or blink past the Wraith King.
Yep.
But Dragon Knight, as a front line, what he does really well is he has a very low short cooldown stun. He also has a splash damage.
Yeah,
so
I think
if you're trying
big.
To run by, those what you call Dyer's the attack of opportunities are quite strong.
I mean, the thing is, Wraith King also has a spammable stun.
Right, so but this is a range attack.
Exactly, that's the difference. I mean, it also has longer range than the Dragon Tail, but the range damage when he's in Dragon form, like that's the kind of thing that sets him apart from Wraith King. And I think that's why we don't see him picked up as a carry, because he's just kind of kiteable, you know? DK can just literally, I mean, you'd see him in these fights. He's attacking people, doing the splash damage, pushing the towers. He's got it all. All
right, here comes another Blink Overgrowth here. Dragon looking for that vacuum. It's not going to...
Interrupts the animation on the Overgrowth, and Tree dies for nothing.
Oh, no. And you're going to have DJ coming and trying to do as much as he can. But again, under 4 HP, 40 HP regen per second.
Not sure about this wall, I've got to say. It's like tucked up along the side there like a curtain. Not really doing much.
I think they're blocking.
Rubik stole the dragon form. That is a good-looking double dragon.
Why is the Pugnant Invoker in there? I think they're blocked in there. What?
Yeah, he. I think
they've got vacuum up there.
Yeah, they got vacuumed up there.
I see.
They didn't want to go through the wall until their pals were there. So this is going to be another Rax here, I think. There's no reason for them to turn back now. Get the melee Rax. Look at they're going to get the range, actually. Look at the amount of damage they do. It's just crazy. Another vacuum.
That's a good one. But again, where's the damage coming in? The Death Ward, you mean drop on the high ground here? And the Witch Doctor is just
Double kill. Double kill for Witch Doctor. That is what you're talking about. GG cold.
Yeah, and that's really the let it go.
Fantastic. Yeah. Well played, LGD. I thought they had a really good game plan. They executed it pretty much perfectly.
Yeah, this is a really refreshing draft, and this is not the case where like a weak team goes against a stronger team and cheese them out.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, this is not like, hey, we need to win the game in a 48-minute push. And
yeah.
Just go.
But that's the lineup that Orange should have picked. I mean, that was... Look at the Invoker. He didn't get a single kill. Only died once because it just wasn't a fight-heavy game. It was like 12-5 at 30 minutes.
They lost the trial lane, too. Like, in the beginning, it was the LGD that had to protect the Invoker bottom. And then they gave up a kill to the Rubik or whatever the case was.
Yeah.
But I really think this is why you don't second pick Slark.
Yeah, no.
Because the hero has issues.
He does. I mean, we saw them in that game. He couldn't get anything going.
Yeah.
But really well played.
All right. That was a very quick, short one. I hope you guys enjoyed it. We're going to go upstairs. I don't know what the game is coming up next, but we should try to join the lobby and have us get kicked. So have fun watching the next game from BTS because those BTS dollars. I'm kidding, guys. GG.